Now we come to the next sutta, number 6, Akankeya Sutta. If a monk should wish, thus have I heard. On one occasion, the Blessed One was living at Savati in Jeta's Grove, Anathapindika's park. There he addressed the monks thus, Monks, Venerable Sir, they replied. The Blessed One said, Monks, dwell possessed of virtue, that is moral conduct, possessed of the Patimokkha, restrained with the restraint of the Patimokkha, perfect in conduct and resort, and seeing fear in the slightest fault, trained by undertaking the training precepts. Stop here for a moment. This Patimokkha, I think in Mandarin is Poloti Mucha, and is a set of precepts for the monks. In the Theravada tradition, we have 227 precepts. And in the Mahayana tradition, they have 250 precepts for the monks. The precepts are almost identical, only there's a slight variation. I mean, some they put in front, it should be at the back and all that. And also they've added a section on concerning the stupa. When you're near the stupa, you should be more respectful. You should not urinate in the direction of the stupa. You should not shit around the stupa. And you should not carry a corpse under the stupa. The stupa in those days probably was like a elevated structure with the relics at the top and at the bottom people could pass across, could walk across. So that's why they say you're not supposed to carry a corpse under the stupa and all that. So the Mahayana monks, they have even 23 precepts more than the Theravada, and the precepts are almost identical. But unfortunately nowadays they don't put much emphasis on the precepts. So this Patimokkha is the set of the 200 over precepts. This is the Patimokkha, and this is recited every 2 weeks on the Uposatha day. The lunar calendar, it's the 15th and the 30th day of the lunar calendar. If you don't have 30 days, then it's 29 days. And the Buddha continued, Monks, if a monk should wish, may I be dear and agreeable to my companions in the holy life, respected and esteemed by them. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, not neglect meditation, be possessed of insight, and dwell in empty huts. If a monk should wish, may I be one to obtain robes, arms, food, resting place, and medicinal requisites. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, not neglect meditation, be possessed of insight, and dwell in empty huts. Similarly, if a monk should wish, may the services of those whose robes, arms, food, resting place, and medicinal requisites are used bring them great fruit and benefit. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, when my kinsmen and relatives who have passed away and died remember me with confidence in their minds, may that bring them great fruit and great benefit. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I become a conqueror of discontent and delight, and may discontent and delight not conquer me. May I abide transcending discontent and delight whenever they arise. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I become a conqueror of fear and dread, and may fear and dread not conquer me. May I abide transcending fear and dread whenever they arise. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I become one to obtain at will, without trouble or difficulty, the four jhanas that constitute the higher mind, and provide a pleasant abiding here and now. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I contact with the body and abide in those liberations that are peaceful and immaterial, transcending forms. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I, with the destruction of three fetters, become a stream enterer, no longer subject to perdition, bound for deliverance, headed for enlightenment. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I, with the destruction of three fetters and the attenuation of lust, hatred and delusion, become a once returner, Sakadagamin, returning once to this world to make an end of suffering. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I, with the destruction of the five lower fetters, become due to reappear spontaneously in the pure abodes, and there attain final nibbana, without ever returning from that world. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I wield the various kinds of supernormal power. Having been one, may I become many. Having been many, may I become one. May I appear and vanish. May I go unhindered through a wall, through an enclosure, through a mountain as though through space. May I dive in and out of the earth as though it were water. May I walk on water without sinking as though it were earth. Seated cross-legged, may I travel in space like a bird. With my hand, may I touch and stroke the moon and sun, so powerful and mighty. May I wield bodily mastery even as far as the Brahma world. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I with the divine ear element, which is purified and surpasses the human, hear both kinds of sounds, the divine and the human, those that are far as well as near. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I understand the minds of other beings, of other persons, having encompassed them with my own mind. May I understand the mind affected by lust as affected by lust, and the mind unaffected by lust as unaffected by lust. May I understand the mind affected by hatred as affected by hatred, and a mind unaffected by hatred as unaffected by hatred. May I understand a mind affected by delusion as affected by delusion, and a mind unaffected by delusion as unaffected by delusion. May I understand a contracted mind as contracted, and a distracted mind as distracted. May I understand an exalted mind as exalted, and an unexalted mind as unexalted. May I understand a surpassed mind as surpassed, and an unsurpassed mind as unsurpassed. May I understand a concentrated mind as concentrated, and an unconcentrated mind as unconcentrated. May I understand a liberated mind as liberated, and an unliberated mind as unliberated. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I recollect my manifold past lives, that is one birth, two births, three, 100, 1,000, etc. Thus with the aspects and the particulars, may I recollect my manifold past lives. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I with the divine eye, which is purified and surpasses the human, see beings passing away and reappearing, inferior and superior, fair and ugly, fortunate and unfortunate. May I understand how beings pass on according to their actions. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, etc. If a monk should wish, may I, by realizing for myself with direct knowledge, here and now enter upon and abide in the deliverance by mind and the deliverance by wisdom that are taintless with the destruction of the taints or asavas. Let him fulfill the precepts, be devoted to internal serenity of mind, not neglect meditation, be possessed of insight, and dwell in empty huts. So it was with reference to this that it was said, monks, dwell possessed of virtue, possessed of the Patimokkha, restrained with the restraint of the Patimokkha, perfect in conduct and resort, seeing fear in the slightest fault, trained by undertaking the training precepts. That is what the Blessed One said. The monks were satisfied and delighted in the Blessed One's words. So here you see the Buddha says, dwell possessed of moral conduct, possessed of the Patimokkha, uphold the precepts, restrain with the restraint of the precepts, perfect in conduct and resort. Conduct is our bodily conduct. Resort is where we go to. We're not supposed to go to unsuitable resorts for a monk. Not supposed to go to a place where there are prostitutes, not to go to a place where there's a widow alone, not to go to alone to the monk, to the nun's quarters, etc. Not to go alone to where a single woman is staying by herself and all that. So this resort. So Buddha always says to see fear in the slightest fault. And then the Buddha says, if the monk should wish to attain all these desirable things that are mentioned here, from the simple things like obtaining the requisites up to psychic powers and liberation, then he should fulfill the precepts, be devoted to serenity of mind, tranquility of mind, that means samatha, practice samatha. Here, not neglect meditation. Meditation in the Buddha's teachings always refers to the jhanas. Be possessed of contemplation, vipassana. Vipassana in the Buddha's teachings refers to contemplation of the four objects, body, feelings, mind, and dhamma. And dwell in secluded places. So that's the way the Buddha expects monks to practice. Keep the precepts, practice samatha meditation, and then practice contemplation. That means study the Dhamma and contemplate, and dwell in secluded places like forest monasteries. Then if whatever a monk wishes to obtain, then he can obtain